A happy welcome back to social sciences class, all my young minds. Today we are going to come across the concept called the Great Economic Depression, which had a devastating impact upon world economy in the last century, that is 20th century. What are the causes for it and what are the consequences of it? And what economists stated regarding this Great Economic Depression, and how governments like US responded, taking inspiration from Great Britain, which adopted some social security measures during World War I. But it not. And also, what was the adverse condition of Germany during this Economic Depression, and how Hitler got an opportunity to bounce to highest level to capture total authority and to carry on his authoritarian rule in Weimar Republic or Germany. So these are all things we are going to come across. What was the economic condition, social condition of Germany is the last part. In this video, very particularly, we are going to come to economists, opinion of economists, why this happened, Great Economic Depression occurred, what were the different views expressed by them. These things we are going to come in this video. Next will be the social welfare measures that were taken by the government of United States of America, where FDR Roosevelt became the prime minister, president of United States of America. Taking inspiration from the Britain's policies, which Britain adopted during World War I, and how to counter the market capitalism, what are the measures required, what is the welfare state. These are all things we are going to come across in the next video, which will be continued after this. So now, I want to make you clear, Great Economic Depression means very worst economic condition prevailed around the world. What is the cause? The very immediate cause, one more question important, Nana, to remember. The very immediate cause is fall in the demand, decline in the demand, fall in the prices of the goods. Decline in the demand means demand for goods reduced. But it so, and fall in prices. Why it happens? What happened? Generally, the main cause being the collapse of stock exchange of United States of America called Wall Street. Why Wall Street? When did it happen? It happened on 29th October 1929, which happened to be a Tuesday. Today is also a Tuesday. Which happened to be a Tuesday, and which is noted as Black Tuesday in world history. 29 October 1929, there happened something. In the United States of America, the people will be investing in the shares. Shares are nothing but none. They are the listed companies. Listed companies means which are permitted by some stock exchange board. In India, stock exchange board is Stock Exchange Board of India, SEBI. Like that, in America, Wall Street is one of the stock exchange board. So in that have to give permission to the industries or factories to go into the public and collect the shares from the public, from the people. So the best indicators and analyzers of the share values and all are two bodies in the United States of America. One is the Dow Jones. And NASDAQ. These are the agencies which will be giving weightage to the share value of companies. And in that good order, in this 30 major companies' share value is decided by Dow Jones. Dow Jones was having very good that weightage, giving other capacity. So what happened is Dow Jones started getting decline value of shares, that is something its weightage started getting declined by from something 305.5 dollars to somewhere 270 to 230 dollars and so on. A sharp fall was there from 24th October to Black Thursday, it is called 24th October to 29th October 1929. Black Thursday, and the day before this is 28th October, it is called Black Monday. It is all of the black days. But the actual cause for the Great Economic Depression is was the incident that happened on 29th 10th 1929. What happened? The stock market of United States of America, Wall Street, got collapsed. Why it got collapsed? When the Dow Jones value got a decrease on Thursday of October, 24th October, investors lost their confidence in the companies which were earlier certified by this Dow Jones. And they started disinvesting, means taking away their investments from the that company's share. But they started selling, we can say they started selling the shares of the companies when they lost the confidence. When selling was high and buyers are very less, automatically the share values fallen down of those companies. And ultimately, companies have to pay back to, when people are selling the shares, they have to pay back. So in this process, the whatever the capitals are remaining with the companies and industries and factories, they started diminishing. When they started diminishing, they started producing less quantity of goods. Got it? Less quantity of goods when they started producing. What happened? The demand increased for the goods. Increased the demand pulled the prices. Increased the demand pulled the prices. Prices means, see, there are 10 people to buy in this market, and so two are there in the, available in the market. Naturally, what happens, the demand will be increasing, and the shopkeeper will be selling 25 rupees marker at a cost of 50 or 100, whatever he likes. When 10 markers are available, only two people are there, what happens to the product value, demand to the product? It will decrease. When it decreases, the shopkeeper says, he want to save his skin. 10 markers are there, only two are the buyers. So what he does, he decreases the price of the thing. Got it? So this is demand supply formula. Demand supply is less, demand will be more. So they thought the prices will be reduce the supply, demand will increase, and people will come running and they will be buying the goods. But once the demand decreases, automatically the prices got increased. Got it? Then there is no one to come and buy this goods. Once there is no one, again prices started falling down. Goods are there only because the prices got increased. And common people are not interested to come and buy because whatever the investments they based already lost. They invested and now they got, they invested 100 rupees per share. Now they got only 20 or 30 rupees per share because the industries, owners of industries could not give back that 100 rupees what they paid. So naturally they lost their purchasing capacity. When purchasing capacity became low, industrial production also became low. And demand made the price to go high, and price started coming down after a certain time because to make available to everyone to buy. But by that time there was an adverse impact not only in the United States of America but in the entire world. Why? Because in the investors, among the investors who invested in this Wall Street stock market, there are governments from the different parts of the world. It got interlinked. Their people, what they collected from their people through banks, that money got invested over here. And when that money got invested over here in the Wall Street, in these industries which are certified by Dow Jones, when the industries lost their rhythm, and that led to the disinvestment, those countries started pulling back their investments and so on. But they did not get there, they invested 100, like people, they invested 100 rupees, they got only 20 or 30 rupees. In this way, too, and the banks have to pay interest to the people who deposited money. So there is collapse of one, like a cycle, like cycles standing in a cycle stand. What happens now if you we hit one cycle, a row continues one after one after one after will be falling down, chain link. So here also world economy was changing because of investments made by different countries in the stock exchange of United States of America called Wall Street. What is the base they were invested in here? Because of the credibility given by the Dow Jones. So in this way, when the Dow Jones share weightage itself started dropping from 305.5 to 230, automatically the old countries, governments who invested in Wall Street, they started taking back their investment. This created a heavy pressure upon the industries. Industries lost their economic rhythm, and that ultimately resulted. And here, even these governments which invested from different parts of the world, they invested 100 rupees, they got only 30 ma. It's enough. Let us go with at least. If not, we'll be, if we are there for some more time, there will be much more problem. Even we not get 30 rupees. So they started rushing for disinvestment. In this process, industries can't sustain that pressure. They lost their economic rhythm. And they reduced their production, and they tried to increase the demand, but demand did not get increased, more prices got increased, and whatever supply is there, that supply, as they can't sell, again they started reducing the prices. This is what, that is declining demand, falling prices is the immediate cause for great economic depression that occurred in 1929. And the starting was on 29th October 1929. But its impact got carried up to 1939 till the First World War, Second World War began. Second World War began on 1st September 1939. So up to that time, the adverse impact of, or drastic impact of this Great Economic Depression continued upon the world countries, most of the world countries. But it, right. Now we'll be seeing what happened because of Great Economic Depression. What are the consequences? There was a loss of employment by 25% in United States of America. Only in United States of America, 25% of people lost their employment in the USA. And around the world, 33% people lost their employment. Means one third you can go almost, you know, mathematics well. One third people in the world lost their employment. In the world. Whereas 25% people lost their employment. Unemployment prevailed. All of a sudden, unemployment prevailed. So, people lost. You see, people lost job. What happens now? Here, India is witnessing. How many people lost their job regarding this pandemic? 1.89 crore. 1.89 crores. 1.89 crores. I beg your pardon. 1.89 crore people lost their employment because of this pandemic. You can understand, family head loses his job. What will be the problem? Most of the people don't have own houses. They have to buy everything from the markets available in and around. How they can buy? They have money. How they get money? If they work, they get money. So, if one person loses the job, generally, on an average, I'm saying, ma, at least 3 or 4 people living in a family will be out of their day-to-day activity. They can't carry because family head is out of job, no money, they will be unable to, they are unable to meet their both hands at least once in a day. For 130 days or 60 days, they may run the show with the savings. After that, what happens? And at the time of life is, the product value, prices will be increasing. And whatever the little amounts are saved, we have to spend that amount and we have to buy this increased prices, the products with increased prices, and soon that results also get exhausted. So now they will be falling in crisis. Now you see many of the people who bought cars, who bought houses by availing bank loans, now they are under a crisis, acute economic crisis. What it? That is, they have to pay back the bank loans which they availed for home, which they avail for cars, but here employment is dwindling. It's not, they are not certain private sector. Most of the people in this country got engaged in unorganized sector. 92% of people got engaged. Most of the entrepreneurs lost their economic rhythm. Industries lost their economic rhythm. Only Adani and Ambani are very happy in the world because of this pandemic, I think, if I'm not wrong. Most of the manufacturers lost their economic rhythm. And what happened? Cutting down or golden shake hands to the employees are cutting down the cost. These all things, cost cutting started. So when cost cutting started, what happened? They will be mercilessly sending the employees out. Got it? If it is a public sector, they will give golden shake hand. Golden shake hand means when they feel that this company is not going to do well with this number of employees, certain quantity of employees have been reduced, and they will call the employees and say that who are ready to leave, we are going to pay them all the emoluments what they get after their retirement. And whatever the things they get, we are going ready to pay, and we will send them. That is called golden shake hand. That happens with public sector. Private sector, no golden shake hand, nothing worse. Work is not there, no production. What happened to making you be here? So please search another thing, another offer, another employment. We don't require your services, simply they say. If it doesn't have to pay, as they are sending out 2 months or 3 months salary, they will leave it. That's all. And most of the private sector, in India, most of the people are engaged in private sector in India. So naturally what happens, most of them will be getting suffered because of this acute pain caused by the depressive economic aspect. Already India is not doing well for the past 2-3 years. Expected GDP we are unable to achieve. And very currently, from last financial year, it is dwindling here and there, and it's something like that, falling from pan to the pipe. Got it? Already we are suffering with mal performance in the GDP and so on, but that means we could not reach what was witnessed by India for several, almost for a decade, decade and a half, I think, that we lost now. And we are in a bad condition now. So, at that time, pandemic emerged, and that mostly got spoiled out. And tomorrow we may see minus our GDP growth rate and minus also, if the same thing is going to continue. So, see, just as we think of public sector or private sector, school going teachers, public sector is submitting salaries. School going teachers, what is the standards of them on the pandemic? They are selling vegetables, you might have seen in newspapers and so on, lecturers, professors, assistant professors, working in the private sector. And also in hospitals, in hotels, restaurants. How many people will be engaged in this? You can simply understand. They all will be, the restaurants got closed for 3 months. Who will pay you without work? So this is what acute pain started around the world, and that led to a great economic depression, which is very worst and longest one in the world economic history. In the history of world economy, longest and worst economic depression occurred in 1929, and it continued up to 1939. So 33% around the world lost their employment. In only United States of America, 25% of people lost their employment, something 8.5 million, something like that. Right. And because of this, what happened? The prices of agriculture products got down by 60%. Earlier, 100 rupees, they used to pay 60%. That means earlier they used to pay 100 rupees. I think now the product got value of 40 rupees only. A farmer sold a bag of paddy 100 rupees. I think now he is forced to sell that 40 rupees because 60% is down. What down? And this made the farming community to move to a state of pauperization. Pauperization. What is this pauperization? A bad economic status, worst economic status, where the farmer to make his family meet both the ends at least once in a day, got ready to sell himself. Himself means either his land is sold out, they are not getting money sufficient enough. For a few months they can sustain the life. So where they got ready to sell themselves, that bad economic condition prevailed around the world, and the case of Germany is very worse. That particular thing we will be coming in the next chapter. No? Cities turned, centers of decline because factories got closed, industries got closed. and people who came from our rural areas to cities to carry their economic activity to big eke out their livelihood. Now they lost their jobs, they are unable to pay rents, that's why they turned back to their villages. Now cities became centers of decline. Very important point to note, because of great economic depression we got seen. People out there moving away from Hyderabad. What it? Bengaluru, Chennai. People went by walk now when a pandemic was striking. People came from Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar. What it? Rajasthan. They started moving back. Now most of the houses are vacant in Hyderabad city. Got it? And the real estate got down. And not only Hyderabad city, I am quoting Hyderabad because we all know that. And many cities in the country, the economic activity came to a standstill for the past 4-5 months. Got it? So such an adverse, not only India, all world countries are also facing the same. I am not speaking only just about India. But India was having this impact for the past 2-3 years. What I say is the past 2-3 years is bad activity because of policies adopted by the governments. Okay, whatever the governments may be, I don't want to go right. This is what happened, and the life turned very vulnerable for the common people and poor people. Poverty increased, unemployment increased, desolation. Everyone, people started becoming isolated, desolation. They started suffering from and so on. At this juncture, some of the economies have carried certain opinions. What are the opinions carried by them? The economists who supported Karl Marx's socialism. So Karl Marx is one of the early socialists, along with Saint-Simon, Robert Owen, and so on, right? Fourier-Louis Blanc in France. Like this, he is also Engels, Marx, they are socialists, one of the early socialists. So the people who follow the economic principles of Karl Marx, they are called Marxist economists. Marxian economists, the economists who are strong supporters of economic principles advocated by or socialism advocated by Karl Marx are called as Marxian economists. Marxian economists are Marxian economists who pointed fault with the capitalism. Capitalism is cause for this destruction of world economy, was the saying of Marxist or Marxian economists. Got it? Why did they quote so? They showed an example of Russia, which was untouched, or USSR we can call, because in 1922 Russia joined many states and became USSR. And USSR is the only country in the Union of States which did not get influenced by the Great Economic Depression, which did not get shattered its economy. Why? Because there is a balanced growth, agricultural growth, industrial production, and whatever the production happened in that country, it started meeting the needs of their own people. Already I showed you in the previous video, Russia was seen as an untouchable by the Western world, capitalistic world. They did not buy anything, they did not sell anything to Russia, but after the Second Great Depression only, countries like Britain, France started carrying friendly relations with the USSR, and also even United States of America in 1932 started having talks with the USSR. Why? Because this Britain, France, America, these all are capitalistic style of economies. What is the difference between capitalism and socialism? I already clearly mentioned to you. Capitalistic system is a system where material production or goods and service production and distribution is controlled by private individuals with a motive of profit making. You have to remember this definition well. Starting of the topic of unity itself, I said to you. Capitalism is a system where goods and service production and distribution is controlled by private individuals with a motive of profit making. Socialism is a system where production and distribution of goods and services is controlled by government with a motive of well-being of the people, welfare of the people. So all hospitals, education institutions, industries, they will be under control of government to a great extent in a socialist society. In a capitalistic society, it won't happen. So that's what happened. once the Dow Jones got down, automatically its impact was formed upon the industries, and industries stopped their production in a big way, and ultimately that showed that created artificial demand for the goods, and demands were increasing, demand increased the prices where common people can't buy, and again prices started coming down, and also demand also started falling down. So automatically fall, declining the demand, falling price led to great economic depression. If it is controlled by government, this might not happen, was the saying of Marxist economists. That's why they showed an example of USSR also to the world. At the same time, J.M. Keynes, one of the popular economists of the West, he also very clearly reported that when such things are happening, when there is a huge pressure of our industries and factories in paying back money to the investors, at that time only governments might have involved. This economic disaster happened because of uninvolvement of governments. See, governments might have involved, given that funds, some money to that industries as loan or something else, long-term loans and so on. Industries might have given back happily the share value to the people. People get their share value, they might have been happy, and they will be having the purchasing capacity. When they have purchasing capacity, they will buy the goods, and the supply and demand will be in equilibrium, and there is a chance of this destruction. So even J.M. Keynes also opined that his opinion was, whenever such things happen regarding economy, governments have to involve. They have to take the task. That's what we see. Of course, whether it happened or not, now a statement from Prime Minister of India, 20 lakh crores we are going to give to carry an Atmanirbhar, means to uphold the confidence of Indian production activity. He gave a statement. Of course, what is the reality and what is the fact and what is the non-fact? Economists, expert economists knows, or the state's heads will know, because they will be getting the results and fruits of that. Ultimately, they have to travel with the people. So, what it is, whether it is a Joomla or whether it is a Jamla, whatever Joomla means. What we can call to attract someone, we give some gift or something like that, or statement that we will give that and we will carry our work and so on. Whatever it may be, the future course of time will be saying, we don't know what will be the consequence and how the government will be using and what are the restrictions in that particular 20 lakh crores and so on. That's a different story. But governments have come to the rescue of the people, come to the rescue of the industries. Come to the rescue of the agriculture farmers. What it? They have to come to the rescue of the people. Either maybe primary sector production, secondary sector production. Primary and secondary sector are going well. Tertiary sector, secondary sector will be well. What it? If restaurants are running well, that 10 or 20 cleaners who are working are stewards who are taking the orders, they all will get employment. Theatres are running, cinema theatres are running, sometimes people will get 1 theatre, 10 people, 10 theatres, 100 people will get 100 people, 100 into 4, 400 people get there. They can eke out their daily livelihood and they can make both ends twice in a day. So, governments have to respond, they have to involve. That's why there was a pressure on the Indian government, and finally Modi came out with a statement of 20 lakh crore we are going to give to the company industries and every production activity, agriculture or something like that, where everyone will be getting benefited to wear out the people from this bad economic crisis. So I think you understood this concept well, and how next video we are going to come across how United States of America under the leadership of F.D.R. Roosevelt tried to bail out itself from that great economic depression, what is New Deal policy, and how Britain stood as an example for this particular United States of America in countering the great economic depression. What are RRR? RRR is not that one. The run of Rudram Ram, some XYZ is there. Not that. Yeah, it is really reform, recovery. What it is, RRR was introduced by F.D.R. Franklin D. Roosevelt, a man who is in the entire American history who acted as President of the United States of America for 3 times only right? Thank you. And I'll come back with some more information related to measures to counter market capitalism, and also welfare state, what is welfare state, we are going to come across in the next video. After that, we will come across the bad economic condition of Germany during its Great Economic Depression. And then afterwards, that may be tomorrow, after that, rise of Nazism, fascism, and what are the means adopted by Mr. Hitler to get attract huge crowds and Mussolini in Italy, and what destiny they made it out, and what are the plans made by them, how they benefited their country people and created a confidence upon them, and how Hitler tried to take an advantage of the conflict between the two ideologies, capitalism and communism, and how he got elevated himself economically. We are going to see in coming classes. Now after that, we have come to causes for Second World War and consequences of Second World War. After that only we will conclude this chapter. After concluding this chapter, we will go to straight away 19th chapter, because that is related to this chapter. After Second World War, what were the conditions that prevailed in the world? Political, economic conditions, and how things went on, formation of UNO and so on. That will be there in 19th chapter, that is a post-war world. That will be started after this chapter. Right? Thank you all. So, we will meet in next video.